Okay, so earlier today, some interesting new features were added to Claude Code, so we will be going over them, as well as many of the new features from the last 2 weeks. But before getting started, it's worth me mentioning that I have a Claude Code masterclass that teaches you every single feature in Claude Code, as well as many techniques that I've picked up myself from over 1,000 hours of usage, many of which that you will not find anywhere else on YouTube. It will be linked down below alongside a coupon code, and it does have a 7-day money-back guarantee if you're not satisfied. Okay, first of all, they made auto-compacting instant. And I noticed this earlier today because I compacted this conversation and it basically happened immediately. And usually when it came to compacting conversations, it would take about 2 minutes, but now it's much faster. And basically the way that this works behind the scenes is that your .cloud folder in your home directory has a projects folder. And inside of that, if you go to any of your projects, you can then click into any of the sessions that you've had or any of the chats, go to session memory, and then you can see a summary of that session. And basically, every time you send a message to Claude Code or every time it responds to you, it always adds onto the session memory the summary. So you can see it kind of looks like this. You have the session title, and this is a title that Claude Code came up with itself. The current status of the session, which includes anything completed, any discussion points, and open questions. And then like a bunch of other things that you can see described over here. Some learnings, some key results, and then a work log, which is automatically updated every time you send a message. So if I quickly send a message to a chat and say something like, can you tell me a short story? And you can see now it says, user requested short story, Claude wrote a short story about the conversation itself. So basically it's now interesting that every time you're using Claude Code, it's automatically keeping a memory of the entire session. And I believe what's happening is that when you do compact and it's instant, what it's actually doing is it just loads the summary of that session into a brand new session that it was writing as you were going along in the previous session. And if you are interested in what's stored in the session memory, then you can basically just ask Claude Code, where is your session memory stored? And it will tell you the exact location because it knows its own like session ID. And you can see in my case, here it is, and I can just click on that and then see the current status of the session. Anyways, I thought that was a pretty interesting decision, and I guess you can have fun looking at the session memory if you're interested in what Claude Code is doing behind the scenes. Okay, so now agents and bash commands can run asynchronously and send messages to wake up the main agent. So for example, I can spawn a brand new subagent by saying, can you spawn a general purpose subagent to do intensive research online and explain to people why they should take my Claude Code masterclass with a link, and then press enter. And now you can see it spawns up this subagent with this task given to it. And then I can press Control B to move it into the background. And now you can see it's looking for the agent output, but I can press exit because it's listening for the agent output. I can press exit, continue on saying like, hi, tell me a story, for example. And then the chat can continue as normal, like it just told me a story. I can then do /tasks and see that agent is running async in the background. Press enter, click on it to see like how many tokens it's used so far. Then I can also see the token count go up and everything else that it's doing here. And then I can continue doing my work as normal. And finally, once that subagent is done, it will then wake up the main agent again. And then finally, once it is done, it will say agent completed. The research agent has completed its analysis, and Claude Code will use a new tool called the agent output tool to then look at the response that the agent then gave it. And then it will like combine that response into the main agent's task at hand. So you can see now the comprehensive research for why you should take the Claude Code masterclass is now ready, and then I can use this for marketing material or something like that. So this can be pretty useful in situations where you're coding on something. You can get a subagent to then like search to find information in the background and then come back and resume the session once they found that information. Likewise, the same thing also applies for bash commands. So in certain situations, you may be running a npm install command or ffmpeg command or something like that, which may take a while in the background. You can just leave that running in the background and then continue on with any work that you want to do. And the way of doing it with a bash command should be pretty similar to what I just showed you earlier. /stats now provides users with interesting Claude Code stats, such as favorite model, usage graph, and usage streak. So if I do /stats, so these are my stats, and I think they only started recording this recently because I don't see any stats from like this time. So yeah, I'm not sure what's up with that, but basically it seems my favorite model is Sonnet 4.5, and that's probably because I use a lot of Sonnet 4.5 based subagents. I used 10 million tokens so far. My longest session was 1 day and 8 hours, and I've been basically using it every single day. So I can like copy these stats by doing Control S, and then if I go to Twitter and then press Command V, then you can see I can just share the stats online pretty easily. If I press tab to then go to models tab, I can then see how many tokens I've used per day for all the different types of models available. And I can do Control S again to copy this and then go to Twitter and then do Control V to paste it. So yeah, this can be a pretty good way to compare people within the company, maybe for phone or something like that. They now added named session support. So you can do /rename to name sessions and then resume sessions by a particular name that you gave it early on. But I think that may be broken because it doesn't recognize a command /rename. So maybe they will fix it later. But what I have noticed is that if you do /resume, then you can see all your previous sessions, and you can also rename sessions here as well. So if you do R, then you can just rename the session, and I can call this like R, type in YouTube, press enter, and now the session has been renamed to YouTube. And if I want to, I can do Claude --resume, and then put in YouTube, and that will resume that previous session. Likewise, the resume screen now groups forked sessions together and has keyboard shortcuts like preview and rename. So if I go to /resume again, and I can go to previous session like how does autocompact work for you, press P, I can see everything within that session, and I can choose to resume it by pressing enter or pressing escape to go back. And for example, this session over here has narrow, so if I press B, then I can see any previous sessions that existed in that main session. Because I compacted that session, a brand new session was spawned that was forked out of the main session. And then I can resume any of those previous sessions from before it actually compacts to the conversation, which can be pretty handy. Another handy thing is you can press A to then show all your projects, because when you do resume, then you can only see the sessions that happened in that particular folder that you're currently inside. We have now also added support for Claude Rules. So basically with Claude's memory, there are four types of memory locations in a hierarchical structure. So the enterprise, project memory, project rules, user memory, and project memory local. So this is quite a lot, but the way it's loaded in is enterprise is loaded in first, then the project Claude.md file that you may already have. Then you can now define project-based rules. And this basically allows you to modularize your real files better, kind of like cursor rules if you do remember that. So if you scroll down, you can basically see this is a structure. In your .cloud folder, you'd have your Claude.md file inside your project. And then you can have rules for different types of things. If you don't define a path at the very top of the rule, then it will be applied all the time. But if you do define a path, such as in the APIs folder, then that rule will only apply to files within that folder. So you can see how the setup is. It's like pretty similar to cursor rules if you're already familiar with that. Now, of course, the advantage is you can now organize your Claude.md file better and have it only apply to specific folders. So for example, if you have a big mono repo like me for this particular project, I can extract some stuff that only apply to the Cloudflare workers, and then some other stuff that would only apply to macOS application, other stuff that would apply to website, and so forth. I will be covering this in more detail, such as how to get it set up, use symlinks, user level rules and stuff, in my Cloud Code masterclass as well pretty soon. For multiple choice questions, Cloud Code will now use a recommended indicator, with the recommended option being moved to the top of the list. So this can be useful in planning mode when you're not exactly sure which option you should take. Whenever Cloud Code now makes a commit, it will then say which model actually wrote the code here. You can now enable and disable MCP servers quickly by doing /mcp enable and then the server name. So for example, MCP, I can see I have the Superbase MCP installed. I can do MCP disable Superbase, and that will quickly disable the Superbase MCP. If for some reason you want to launch Claude Code without any slash commands, then you can use this. So you can do Claude --disable/commands. And then if you do something like /mcp or /resume, you won't see any other commands available. So I guess this gives you a more minimal, like, just chatting with Claude experience maybe. They now also added a --agent CLI flag to override the agent settings for the current session. And that basically means that if you have some kind of subagent in your session, then you can run Claude Code as that particular subagent. So for example, I have a macOS log analyzer subagent that uses a Haiku model because it doesn't need a more powerful one. I can copy over the name of that subagent, do Claude --agent, put in the name, press enter, and then you can see it will automatically run as the macOS log analyzer subagent. And I'll say, what do you do? And then you can see it says, I'm Claude Code, blah, 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 macOS unified log analysis. So I think that can be pretty cool. You can run Claude Code as any of the subagents that you have in your project. So you can have all the same instructions that the subagents do and actually manually execute a particular subagent. I can also run Claude Code as any of the default Claude Code subagents by doing Claude --agent and plan, for example, and that is the planning subagent that is built into Claude Code. And then if I say, what do you do? Then it will let me know of the planning responsibilities and capabilities that it has. So what this means is by default, if you leave out the agent flag, then Claude Code will run as the main agent that is built into Claude Code. But if you specify an agent flag, then you can use any of the default subagents, like manually like control them, or you can use any of the subagents that you have actually installed or created in your project. And this can be pretty good because usually when Claude Code spawns up subagents, like you can't steer the subagent in any particular way. It just runs and then comes back to you. But in this case, you can probably diagnose subagents to make sure they operate well by actually running the subagent manually and trying to like get a feel for it. They also now added the ability to delegate tasks to Claude Code from Slack. So in Slack, you can go to the app section, search for Claude, and then click on it and press install. Press add to Slack to add it to your workspace. And then it will ask you for like permission and stuff. So you can press allow. And now it says Claude Code is now installed. So we can go back to Slack. And now here we have Claude available. So I can press connect account, then connect to my Anthropic account. Go back to Slack again, and then I can choose a model that's used for conversation, choose whether it's code only or code plus chat, see the organization. And then inside the channel, I can do at Claude and be like, hey, can you add a Chinese translation to a landing page for my application Hyperwhisper? And then Hyperwhisper will transcribe what I just said. And then Claude Code will be like, hey, I'm going to get started with this. But it seems I have to add Claude to the channel first. So I'll add Claude to the channel, and that's organizing, gathering information, and then it will generate me a response. But it's now asking me the repo it should work in because I can't identify that. So this can be pretty useful if you want to work with Claude Code on a like bug fix or something in your team. Or if you have some kind of like channel on your team Slack where you're regularly getting bug fixes or like issues coming in, you can just tag Claude Code. And if you want to extend the abilities, then you can go to Claude, press connect to Slack connector, and within the connectors over here, you can add a custom connector to like the Sentry MCP server or something, or your own logging system. And if you are interested in buying my speech text application Hyperwhisper, then there will be a link and coupon code for that down below as well. I am also working on a Windows version as well, so that will be out within the next month or so. But if you press download now, then you can put in your email and then you'll get notified when the Windows version is out. Anyways, just before ending the video, I remember reading the Measuring Political Bias in Claude, like article that Anthropic wrote. And this graph was pretty interesting because it shows a bunch of different models. It is 1 month old, so some of the models are not on here. But Opus 4.1 was the best at considering opposing or counter arguments to like political problems. And maybe the fact that Claude is better at considering opposing perspectives and counter arguments, that can carry over to it making better decisions when it comes to coding. And I imagine like since Opus 4.1 was the best here, it's quite likely that Opus 4.5 is pretty good as well, or score slightly higher on this like eval, the benchmark thing that they have. Anyways, hopefully that video was pretty interesting and you learned something useful. If you do like this kind of content, then do subscribe to the channel because it lets YouTube know that this is a good video and you will get recommended more videos like this in the future. And if you are interested in my Claude Code Masterclass, then that will be linked down below alongside a coupon code. And I will be updating the class in the next 2 days with all the new features that I just talked about in the video. There's a 7-day money back guarantee if you don't like the class, and so far less than 0.5% of people have asked for their money back. So that's how I know the class is really good, because like people just like enjoy the class and they don't ask for a refund. And yeah, because I've never accepted a sponsor on the channel and never want to keep my videos unbiased, classes like this and my software like Hyperwhisper basically helps keep the channel going. So if you're interested, then do check it out.